pressure down, you pull out. I actually have spring energy, or you pull, so I follow with it. So it's also here. Because I got bump, blah. So his pull accelerates that punch. So he's pulling, and then you go. So it's very logical. I like these forms because Chen Pan Ling designed them very, very logically. Western trained scientists using martial arts, you can see. That's why you use this and not. There's nothing there. I have to pull it back to the general punch. Every last bit of this is like maths. And I love the beauty of it. I think forms, just for the sake of form, is pointless. When you have the inherent mathematics of this, it's the same as BJJ. A lot of people don't appreciate the nature of the lessons taught in these forms. They think it's flowery, it's not flowery. It's maths, and it's maths the same as BJJ is maths. It's just that it's in a non-contact, physical, constant contact environment, you grapple. Your contact is fleeting, it's sliding, it's slipping. And you'll see in the latest fight by Anderson Silva, where he does this, and later on he does a rising drop or two. And people say, oh, it's never going to work. People don't train for that. And the reason they don't train for that in MMA is that their whole goal and structure is to land a powerful punch. Very little is on pure defense. And that pure defense arises when you get a little bit older in Anderson Silva's case, and he can no longer showboat and rely on pure speed. He's now caught a bit short in the way we are in self-defense. So people said, he was so lucky when he did that with a kick. Ah, he's so lucky. I would have got him with a punch. No, unless you're completely feinting that kick and you're always intending. The truth is that all your attention is focused on that leg. So, boom, by the time he's come up with anything, I've got my arms up. It's only momentary. And this is even a temporary thing. Okay, it's temporary. Same with this. You raise your arm, you're blocking, you're deflecting. You don't have time, once again, you don't have time to do anything that's going to fall off. All of this is true. But the reality is that if I set it up mathematically, and I can hit the outside, his next technique is already being negated. Because I'm not doing one, two. I'm doing, if he's there on the inside, much riskier. I already know, mathematically, that's his best option. So I can really tell what he can do. I can beat him to it simply by putting the timing on. So, five, bar, four, one, two. Then, one, two, this, which is from naihanchi. I don't need to go punch with this hand. This is the only application, just showing it's just one option. This doesn't need to, it could be. It could be stop so many things that hand leads. In this particular instance, the lead arm is controlling, checking this end is punching.